Tomorrow we're planning on diving a P-47 Thunderbolt, a small aircraft from the Second World War that had to bail out and ditch into the ocean when it ran out of fuel. If we can get to the site, we can hopefully drop right down onto it.
Is this a photograph of the plane, or at least one of the planes,
mm-hmm.
with the pilot standing beside it? That's amazing, isn't it? I think this is really funny, the fact that they used to actually personalize their planes.
To have to lay it down in the ocean and let it sink to the bottom would be pretty sad. I'm sure he was pleased to get away with his life, but...
It'd be like saying goodbye to a good friend, wouldn't
it? Yeah. The squadron of P-47s were trying to avoid the weather. Some of them were able to land, and five of them had to go up to 20,000 feet to get up into radar zone again by, you know, friendly radar. And when they did that, they ended up burning too much fuel, and they had to ditch in the ocean. This is one of the planes that ditched in the ocean, and the pilot survived.
What I think is fantastic about this is the fact that there were five of these planes that went down on the same day. Four of the others are in too deep a water to dive, and this is the only one within recreational dive limits. The only reason that we can dive here is because this pilot pushed his plane enough to get close enough to that island so that he wouldn't have to swim so far to safety.
To get a chance at combining biodiversity with some real history, at that World War II history, and at that World War II plane history, it pretty much is as good as it gets for me.
I guess when I think about the Second World War and I think about it in respect of Indonesia, I really think about the native people that lived here during those times. And if I put myself in their shoes, I can't help but think how horrifying this war would have been. They wouldn't have wanted any part of this war. And yet, because of these waters and the fact that this area was very valuable, they were thrown in amongst it. Diving on a P-47 plane wreck was like stepping back into history. And if it wasn't for the local Indonesians here, there's no way we would have found it.
Of all places to be marooned, it's not a bad place, hey? The pilots who ditched their planes in the water here ended up swimming ashore and being rescued off the beaches of Wai Island right here. I guess it was only like a day or two before a couple of Catalinas were able to come in and land and pick them up.
You'd almost be gutted to see the rescue crew coming, wouldn't you?
Yeah, exactly. A couple more days of leave, please.
This wreck's at around 90 feet, so we're only going to have probably 25, 30 minutes of bottom time down there. We're going to have to locate it pretty quick and be fairly efficient on this dive.
I barely fell into the water, and there it was.
Ha, that's beautiful. You can see the wing tip, and I think I can actually see some of the machine guns out of the front of the wing.
It really is an incredible shape, considering it's been down here for 70 years. This plane has come to rest upside down. The pilot knew exactly what he was doing in order to come in and try to land this on the ocean.
And I guess aiming ultimately to land close to the island, but not too close to the island.
There are some parts of it that are in remarkable shape, and then other parts like here, big coral pieces that have just taken over the wreck, making it a piece of nature.
When you look at this airplane, there is not one square inch that is not covered in coral.
It almost looks like this psychedelic fighter jet with all these incredible colors of blue and green and yellow. I can only imagine what these four pilots must have been thinking in the last few moments when they were running out of fuel and making that last minute decision to have to land in the ocean.
At a pretty young age, I was given a collection of books that had documented the Second World War, and they were my grandfather's, and he passed away while I was only a few months old, so I never really got to know him. And so, knowing that he fought in the Second World War, I started to really develop an interest in it. And I used to build model airplanes more than anything, and it really sort of blossomed into a love of all things aviation.
I can see the rudder pedals, the gauges with the glass in place. Everything's still right here.
three out of the four blades of the propeller have been bent out of shape upon impact with the water.
I remember building my little plastic scale model, putting this prop right into this engine, even the distinctive shape of that front cowling, not round like most of the World War II fighters, but actually oblong.
I had that model dangling over top of my head for so many years as a kid. To see it in person now and explore it really puts you at a loss for words.
I think time's up. We better start heading up.
I could spend 3 weeks diving wrecks like these that remind me of my childhood and put me in touch with a time that I never had to live through, but I've always been fascinated by. These are the very dives that got me into diving in the first place.